will be Jordan Levas. Jordan Levas to make his final case to the judges tonight. Yeah. All right, Jordan, second time around. Has it gone better?
You think this time? I got farther than
last
time.
Well, yes, you got farther, but have you enjoyed the experience? How's it been different?
That's the only reason I'm here is the experience, man. It's just, like, I had so many people come out each time. It's been fantastic to have all the support. That's more than winning, so that was nice.
But winning wouldn't hurt either.
It shouldn't hurt. I hope not.
Well, that depends on who you get to do shows with, but we'll get to that later, possibly. But you have your chance to make your final case to the judges. 4 minutes on the clock, Jordan, and they're all yours.
All right, awesome. So, I wanted to talk about why the Seahawks should keep Marshawn Lynch. No, I'm kidding. I want to talk about something that's really been messing with me lately. Anybody who listened to this last year knows that baseball is my favorite sport. I talked about it twice. It still is my favorite sport. But the one thing I'm having a real issue with about baseball at this point is that even for me, somebody who loves the game, it's starting to get kind of boring. There were a lot of 3-2 games last year, and sometimes those are cool, but they're cool when they're a novelty. They're cool when they're only sometimes. I really do want the 7-5 slugfest with a walk-off 3-run homer. I want sparks to fly. I want excitement. And no one's going to watch on TV if you're getting 3-2 ball games every single time. So what I'm proposing at this point, I'm going for broke. I say screw it. I want steroids back in baseball. Okay, I want them everywhere. At this point, I don't care. I want dingers, damn it. Everyone wants dingers. Chicks dig the long ball, and steroids provide that long ball. That's all I want at this point. I want when people walk into the locker room, I want them to look left or right. Either way, there's a tub of steroids, and they can just scoop their hand in there and continue on to their locker. I don't care where they come from anymore. Look, I'm sick of seeing the home run champion in this league, whether it be AL or NL, have 34 home runs. That's not a home run champion. That's the winner of a race between nothing but one-legged men. That there is no winner there. I want 60 home runs. I want 70 home runs. I don't want any number under 50 at least, okay? The last guy who hit 50 home runs was Chris Davis. Hey, guess what? He was on drugs. He got suspended for them last year. They're fantastic. They work wonders. I want look, Prince Fielder, okay, he had 50 also, but he was just eating cheeseburgers. But that's like his steroid, sure. The thing is, I can't, like, the worst thing is when you're getting bonus baseball, is what they call extra innings. You know, I'm in the know. Is bonus baseball, when it's a 2-2 game between the Rockies and the Rays, no one wants to watch extra innings between the Rockies and the Rays. That's a horrible game. And it's always now 2-2. I want, if it's 8-8, I'll take that. If there's dingers everywhere, I'll take it. But bonus baseball, there is no bonus baseball if it's terrible. It's punishment ball if it's 2-2 between two crappy teams in 13 innings. Okay? At that point, it's not bonus if you don't want it. Like, I don't drink bonus sulfuric acid. I don't get hit by bonus cars. Okay, bonus baseball has to be good baseball, and right now there is no good baseball. So at this point, I'll take roids, I'll take anything. I need the numbers back up. Look, Fox baseball took a huge hit lately. No one's watching it anymore because it's boring as hell. Runs have gone down, strikeouts have gone up. They tried moving their game to primetime, and it didn't help either. There's baseball now on every night. If you're going to be on every night, you have to provide a fantastic product, and they're not providing it anymore. Because the game has slowed down. So their answer is, oh, well, let's speed it up. Maybe we need to put in a pitch clock. No, people were watching the game when Bonds and McGuire and Sosa were each hitting 70 dingers a year, and you'd tune in for a game between the Cubs and the Pirates, even if the Pirates and the Cubs sucked, because you wanted to see how many dingers got hit. And every time, it was entertaining. You could bank on it 100% of the time. Look, on top of that, if you're not going to bring in steroids, obviously I'm being a little sarcastic here because, you know, I know it's a touchy subject, drugs everywhere. I got offered drugs today, you know, and it's ugly, okay? But the point is, bring the fences in. If you don't want drugs everywhere, which at this point I'm fine with, but if you're not going to put drugs everywhere, bring the fences in. What's so wrong with bringing the fences in? People treat that like it's the worst thing in the world, all right? Bring the fences in, give me steroids, because the only thing worse than steroids at this point is boring baseball, and that's what I'm getting. So in the battle of the lesser of two evils, I'll take steroids at this point.
All right. Jordan Levas, well done. What about reconstructing the kingdom?
What? No, I don't know. No one cares about that. Safe Coast Beautiful.
Yeah, but you can't hit home runs there. They used to fly out of the kingdom like nobody's business.
Then bring in the roids.
All right. Thought I'd ask. Let's see what Isaac and Suk thought of
the
Jordan.
The kingdom's long gone, too. I am thoroughly enjoying watching the three girls over there. We have one of our promotions crew. We have a fangirl. And then we have this gal who I don't know. What is your name? Kristen, nice to see you. She's filming the whole thing. I've watched them all night, and they could not give two S's about any of this. Now, the good news is that is no indictment on you. It's just sports talk. Like, they're not in our target demo. However, I will say that you caught Kristen. You had her she's been, like, playing with her nails, playing with her phone. You had her attention for, like, 30 seconds of that bit.
I was first.
And actually, that's all really
right.
Good.
Yeah.
Here's what's interesting about you. Jordan, you and you know this. The other three guys left in this competition are guys who can be ones. Like they're more polished than you are. You're a little more rough around the edges. But I like the way your brain works, though. You're a two for sure, and I would like to hear a one who can set you up and you can spit out your opinions. That would work for you. The question is, you know, is that enough to win the competition? But you know I like you. I liked you last year, and here you are in the Final Four this year. You're good enough to be here. The question is, can you beat these other three guys who are a little bit more polished?
I don't really care about winning. I just want to talk sports, like, for a while and scream crazy things like I do at my friends all the time, and they're sick of hearing it. I just want to yell things now. I want to propagate my message.
Just like Suk.
Yeah. And, Kristen did have, like, a 2.5-minute stretch where she did not look up from her nails. We had a clock going on, and it was fantastic. To be brutally honest, you're not good enough to win. The other three are better than you are. They are.
I love you, Suk.
They just are. There is a separation. I think that the three others are stronger contestants. You have a place. You really do. You might have, mate, you have the best personality of anyone in this thing. You may have the most raw potential. But as far as winning the contest goes, they've just done a better job. But as Isaac said, I would be real interested to see what you could do being put in a, because this isn't radio. You know, this is a skills competition. You with the right guy, you have a personality that I like to listen to. I do, like Rob said, I like the way your brain works. You're funny. I think you're probably the funniest of the three here. And so don't take that as an indictment. It's just in this competition, there's just certain skills that I think other people are better, but you may have something that they don't. So remember, it wasn't just the winner here that ended up on our airways. We found three. I could totally see that with you ending up on a show in some shape or form and allowing that personality to come out, because it really is good and it's funny and I like you.
I'll take it.
All right, let's hear from the judges. Jeff Austin.
Suk's going to have the conversation with HR if he's going to hire multiple people this year, I think. So. Well, I'm glad to know that that's set before me that's my task. But no, seriously, I mean, one thing you've got going for you is you're sincere. I think people listen to you because they believe that you believe what you're saying. There's nothing for effect, nothing phony. You're natural. And that's a great strength to have. I think you also were extremely relatable with this topic because most people who pay any attention to baseball, whether they're diehard or more often not so diehard, agree with you. Baseball's getting boring and they need to do something about it. Now, yeah, I mean, more drugs, probably not a realistic solution, but at least you offered something else, like move the fences in too. But, you know, I'm with these guys. I wouldn't really add anything else except to say, yeah, I do like the way your brain works too.
Ryan Cooley.
You're always entertaining, Jordan. I'm glad you're in the Final Four, man. I love the line, the only thing worse than drugs is boring baseball. I thought that was awesome. It was a great way to wrap up that segment. I'm a huge baseball fan too, and I'm with you. I canceled my DirecTV package. I'm not finding the time for baseball, which makes me really sad.
Oh, because the Yankees aren't winning 100 games a year anymore.
Hey, you shut your mouth. Wow. About the Yankees.
Wow.
And the Royals are going to the World Series.
Good luck next year.
So, See you in 29 years.
One time?
I bet you're a Ducks
one
fan,
time?
Too, right? Been a Ducks fan since the beginning, baby.
They're
going and losing,
hey,
by the way.
Cute little club.
Cute little club. That went to the World Series.
Yeah.
And lost.
And lost, that's right. Thank you, Dirt. No, but hey, Jordan, again, I agree with what the guys are saying, but again, your delivery is different. That's what I like about it. The other guys,
I'm not saying I did completely disagree with Suk, but their delivery is different. There's something about you that's different than the other four, and that's what I've always liked about you. So great job.
Jordan Levas.
I wanted to hear from Dusty. He always has nice things to say about me.
Oh, we got. I'm over. I gotta
Dusty's
keep
an
us
idiot.
On the clock. So well done, Jordan.